Good morning, Dubbers. We are on the road again. I am. What day is it? Friday. Friday the 8th. Yep, Friday the 8th. Well, it could be the 9th. Look at the date. Friday the 8th of July. And I was supposed to do two class one jobs yesterday and today for the same company, but long story short is I asked the question. I said, are they okay with newly qualified drivers? You've asked that question, yes? Oh yes, absolutely, no problem. No problem. So I get there, present my pass certificate, because my license has now gone off, and yes, it turns out they want 2 years experience, which is a crop really, because several of our drivers from the agency have gone in and done work for this company, and none of them have had 2 years experience, not one. I think he's had eight drivers in there, even one that was doing night run. So I suggest what's happening is, the reason they looked at me is because I presented my pass certificate. Yeah, which you're quite legally entitled to drive on. But they're handing licenses over, and the only thing I can think of is, yeah, they probably photocopy them, but they don't look at the pass date. They mustn't do. And remember I told you before, sometimes these companies have got a knack of, when they get really busy, these rules all of a sudden bend. And like my boss said at the agency, some days it's just down to who you get in the office, you know? So it's not for me to get involved in that side of it. I let them scrap it out between them. So yeah, I'm not. Anyway, I pushed the panic button, phoned the other agencies. In fact, I only phoned one, and it was early doors. And she said, yeah, actually, I've got a job delivering sound equipment and lighting stuff for an event at Westminster. So that's what I'm doing. And fortunately for me, my wife has broke up on holiday, so I haven't got to worry about my son, you know, getting back in time. I've picked this truck up today. It's a 15 plate MAN. Lovely, nice, clean. I love these trucks, I really do. Picked it up in Mansfield. I was sat at the gate for over an hour and 15 minutes. And one of their drivers was overnighting in his cab. As he pulled out, I could get in because I pressed the intercom button, and the voice on the end of it, which was like an external security, said, I need a password for you to get in. I went, I haven't got a password. Let me check my text, nothing. No mention of password or anything. He said, oh, well, somebody will be there at 7. So I waited, quarter past seven, 20 past seven come round. I phoned the agency, he said, look, nobody's here. I was here 10 minutes early. You know, I'm good to go. Do you know the score? No, I Googled the name of the company, tried phoning their office. No joy, not open. Turns out I was supposed to be given somebody's mobile number to call when I got there, and he'd instruct me. And I'm not telling you the procedure of this particular company, but I went in and I was told where an envelope was left. I pulled that out and all the details of the job are in that. So I'm now on the way to Peterborough to another events company to pick a load of gear up. I was supposed to be there at 10 o'clock. Well, that's 7 minutes away and I'm 16 miles. And I haven't found the jet engine on this one yet, so the guy's phoned me. He said, how are you looking? I said, well, I think I'm going to be about 20 minutes late. Well, hopefully we can reduce that to maybe 15 minutes. But that's the best I can do. Yeah. So I take this gear down to Westminster, help them off with the load. I should be as helpful as I can because I don't like sitting around. You know, whatever they need me to do, I'll just crack on. And then I'm staying down there and coming back. All the gear's coming out of Westminster after 10 o'clock at night, Saturday night. I have to come back up here to Peterborough, drop the gear off, then back over to Mansfield to drop the lorry off, and I'm done. So I've got two nights out. Are you recording? Yes, you are. Have I been talking for 15 minutes? No, I haven't. Weather's not brilliant. There's a guy on YouTube that does this kind of work all the while, and I've had quite a bit of banter with the guy. I'm friends with him on Facebook, and I first hooked up with him on Trucker J's. He launched a forum, that's it. I'm getting old. Yeah, he launched a forum, and it had legs. It was really good, and there's some nice people on it, and Hammy was one of them, and he got a lot to say. He was very active, as I was at the time, but it just seemed to die off. Nobody uses it. Jay doesn't use it, so I don't know what's gone on there. But yeah, no point in trying to flog a dead horse, I think, which is a shame. But yeah, so that's how I got to know this guy. But he does this kind of work all the while, and he's very good at putting a video together. If you want to check his channel out. He's done a couple of time-lapse videos. He's a couple of videos back. Come on, get up to speed, you noggins. Oh, you put your foot down now. It's the wrong time. You put your foot down when you get on the bleeding slip road. Yes. But he did a time-lapse video of this particular day, setting up the concert, etc. It was cracking. I find it fascinating. So yeah, go check him out. He's Hammy. Is it Hammy99? I'll put the link below on this one. But yeah, that's what he does for a living. Up down the country. Just recently been up in Scotland. I've got to watch that one. That'll be interesting. Trying to make time up. We're going to lose 20 minutes, which, bearing in mind, I sat at that gate for the best part of an hour and a half. It's not too bad, is it? See, that's the difference between running loaded and unloaded. fair bit of torque this vehicle. It, when I got in it this morning, it was accelerating really well. I hope it's just the same as loaded. I'm going to miss Ken Bruce's Ken Bruce's Potmaster. He realised he made a mistake. I'm trying to clear the road. Dipstick. Sometimes, to get a little, you've got to give a little, you know what I mean? Grease them wheels. Here we go. Speaking of greasing the wheels, a moped rider will do nicely. Look how ticket, you can see where it's going, look. Who's ordering takeout this time of day? Lazy beggars. You know what? That guy that was coming opposite to me. He's supposed to clear the let it clear. Thank you. Before proceeding. Oh, that's a curb. But he didn't. Do you know why he didn't? Because he was using his mobile phone in his lap. Amazing what you can see from up here. Anybody read his number plate on the bike? Think he's ever cleaned it? How come they don't get done? Because they've got them number plate recognition light cameras. Oi! Step back. Busy on his bloody mobile phone to realise. See, that's why you're not supposed to pull in that box. Thank you. Stood in the road on his mobile phone, oblivious to the big lorry wanting to squish him. Come on, let's have you cross. Uber Eats is all fancy, look, posh bike, all the gear, look, nice box on the back. That girl looks at me like she's just been told off by her dad. She won't walk across on green light. I wag my finger. I give her the finger wag. No, don't you dare. I didn't think the route masters were still allowed. Okay, look, old route master, I love them. I do love them. How much character has that got? Oh, that was a good segment. I think that's a permanent bus lane. Slots we can use it. Last time I was in London, I was in a 7.5 tonner. Albeit quite a big 7.5 tonner. And I took one of the branches with me, parked in one of these little leafy side streets outside this woman's house. And this woman shouted obscenities at me. What the effing hell are you doing with that effing tree? It was overhanging, we didn't see it. Pulled up, it was crunch, didn't do any damage, just took the biggest branch off. We ended up taking the branch away with us, we didn't want to leave it.
by the word that connects us. Connected by the number 9. And the thinking visions and breathing rhythms. We got ocean over your loops. It's a deeper meaning, a powerful feeling. Brings us to myths we're told. And it's only clean water that supports the things that you try to grow. It's not a single living thing that needs to be left out. You can find a God that's missing yourself. Speakers make a pattern in the sand. When the frequency is just right, oh man, it's really rather rad.
It'll all of a sudden become very familiar. There we go. Westminster Abbey. I don't burn like that anymore. And that is where we're delivering to, Methodist Central Hall, Westminster. Right in the middle. Lots of tourists walking around here. I look like a tourist. caught some of that conversation. That was funny. Bless him. Bless him. We are stereotyped in this country. This is what the world knows us for, right? This, red telephone boxes, red buzzers. This is how we all roll, right? This is what the rest of the country looks like, right? Do you know what? Come and see this. Great. Take your photos. Go and stand in a red box. Yaddy yaddy yaddy. Right? But then come up north. Come a bit further up north. We'll go down to Cornwall. See the beautiful coastline. Come into the Derbyshire Peaks. Have a mosey round. The Lake District. Keep going. Keep going all the way up. Cumbria. How about Cumbria? Dip down into Wales if you like. Then come up north a bit more. We've got lots to offer. There we go. Oh no! I've missed my 11 o'clock tea break! Would you Adam and Eve it? Bloody hell! And how long I can sit here on this solid yellow line. It's not double, it's just solid, which means I can't park here. But I need to go into this road just here. And if I go into it now, or you should get stuck in it, or you'll get, I should be blocking the road, and then everybody's going to be tooting at me, because that's what they do down here in London, see? Up in the countryside, we get none of that. But yeah, down here, or he goes down there, and they'll be tooting and rooting and swearing and jeffing and all sorts at me, and that's not good. So I'm sat here waiting for the boys to get down that loaded me up, because they were following me now. They said they'd be beating me down here, so I must have done pretty well, I think. I'm rocking and rolling now. Yeah, so the situation is, I collected the lorry in Mansfield, remember that? Then I went to Peterborough to collect this road, remember that? Then I went to, then I've come down here to Clandon. Drop this off. Then I've got to go and disappear for 24 hours. I don't know where I'm going, but I'll get paid a set amount of money for having a day off down here, you see? Which is, it's quite a decent amount of money, I've got to be honest with you, for doing nought. And then I've got to come back here at, and I do believe I'll be loading up out of that door there, because residents live down there and they moan after 10 o'clock if you start banging. So we'll be loading out of there. I pick this lot up again, take that back up to Peterborough, drop that off, and take the wagon back to Mansfield, and that's done. So I'll get a minimum of 10 hours today, that's guaranteed. A minimum of 10 hours on the Sunday, plus that big chunk for having your day off, your rest period. That'll be all right. So that'll be good, because then I'm on holiday next week anyway. So I'm not gonna run out of dry time. But my boss at the agency is rolling me up a bit stroppy today, a bit stressed. Wants to know if I can do a class 1 job out of Nottingham, a company that I've driven class 2 for. You've seen me drive for them a time or two. So yeah, it'll be first class 1 job Monday, hopefully. I turned up the other day for that job in Derbyshire, and I thought I was going to be scared, but I wasn't, you know. I hadn't got nerves or anything. Whether they kicked in went off. I'm just a man, I can't help it. Sorry, I had to show you that. God, I'm confident. God, goodness gracious, mate. Oh, put me off my stride now. My missus watches us, I'll be in for a thick ear. Yeah, so I don't know if the nerves had kicked in after I picked the unit up, I don't know, and once I get out there, but I've got to get past it. I've got to just jump in feet first, get on with it. Can't do any more, eh? And while the blinking out, do you want to pass the grass on? You don't want to jump in? But I think it was nice that the way, I know one or two of you had your training this way, Stevie P, he went out with a company that he's now working for trained him. And the guy that he was comfortable with, the guy that was teaching him, and they spent a few weeks out on the road, and he got his training in what I would call real time, which I don't think you could beat that, to be fair, because even the reversing exercise and whatnot, they're all just, you know, they're not three dimensional, they're very two dimensional, you know. So guide up last splashing. Got the map out. Oh, is this one of the lads?
No, it's not.
I do like people watching. I like sitting here and just watching people and go about their daily lives. Fascinating. I could sit in a window looking out all day long. As long as I've got a steady flow of Yorkshire Gold, I'd be happy. Sad, innit? Japanese tourists.
Hello.
They're good at being tourists, aren't they, Japanese? They do tourism very well. I quite like his waterproof jacket. I like that grey. Grey and green ensemble. Right, turn you off. I've got nothing else to show you for now. I shall run out of memory at this stage. Toodles.